Kidz Praiz. Cabbage Kidz Praiz. What the best Kidz Praiz in town.
Said, have no other gods but God to worship, idols just won't do. Be careful with the way you use God's name and keep Sunday special too. Honor your parents, don't take any lives, and when you're old enough to marry, be true. Do not steal, lie, or want those things that don't belong to you. These are 10 simple rules God gave to me and you. The good Lord said, you better listen to me. If you follow these rules, then they will set you free. Because I want you to live a happy life and help others to be happy too. So when things go wrong, these words will get you through. And the Lord said, have no other gods but God to worship, idols just won't do. Be careful with the way you use God's name and keep Sunday special too. Honor your parents, don't take any lives, and when you're old enough to marry, be true. Do not steal, a lie, or want those things that don't belong to you. These are 10 simple rules God gave to me and you. And the Lord said, have no other gods but God to worship, idols just won't do. Be careful with the way you use God's name and keep Sunday special too. Honor your parents, don't take any lives, and when you're old enough to marry, be true. Do not steal, a lie, or want those things that don't belong to you. These are 10 simple rules God gave to me and you. Well, these are 10 simple rules God gave to me and you.
Into their drinking water. But had the Israelites obeyed and honored the rules, they would not have had to drink Kool-Aid made out of gold flakes and water. So even when we may not like the rules, we still must obey.
Okay, kids, let's do a brief reminder of the Ten Commandments, okay? What have we learned so far? We learned that thou shalt have no other gods before me. Remember, no other gods, okay? Two, this is a cool one, remember? Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image. Do not bow down to any graven image. Three, looks like a W, right? Words. Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain. Watch your words. Watch your words. Four. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. Check this out. 4. So do you remember whenever, let me do this on this side. What does this look like? Does it look like a church with a steeple? 4. Church with a steeple. Honor the Sabbath and keep it holy. Starting with the commandment number 5. So commandment number 5 is honor thy father and thy mother. Now if you salute, 5. You salute your parents. 5. Salute your parents. You honor your mom and dad. 6. Thou shalt not kill. Don't kill. Just do that again. Don't kill. Okay. 7. Thou shalt not commit adultery. There are 2 people in a marriage, not 5. 2 people in a marriage, not 5. So what's new? We learned 5. Honor your mom and dad. 6. Do not kill. And 7. Thou shalt not commit adultery. There are 2 people, not 5, in a marriage. Now, let's break it down. Another word for honor is respect. Oh, respect like Aretha respect?
R-E-S-P-E-C-T, find out what it means to me. R-E-S-P-E-C-T, take out T-C-T.
No, not that kind of respect. Not that respect. Respect is a way of treating or thinking about something or someone. For example, if you respect your parents or your teacher, you admire them and you treat them well.
So what you're saying is that the 5th commandment says for us to honor and obey our parents every day?
Exactly.
So what's the next commandment that we're going to learn tonight?
The 6th commandment, thou shalt not kill.
Wow. That's a really short commandment. There's just 4 words in thou shalt not kill. But, man, they're pretty powerful.
It sure is. And we can also think about it like letting life live. Just like the song that our favorite puppets are going to sing.
Number 6, ladies and gentlemen, do not murder.
Breathe his
That's such a cool song. Didn't you guys like it? Such a cool song. Live and love and let life live. So that was the sixth commandment. Now, Sister Monica, what does the seventh commandment say?
Thou shalt not commit adultery.
Oh, wow. Well, that's just for grown-ups, right?
Well, ultimately, yes. But kids know that when a man and a woman marry, they make promises to each other. They go something like this. I take thee to be my wedded husband or wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love, to cherish, till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance. When someone who is married breaks their promise to their spouse or their mate, they have committed adultery.
Oh, I see. So when you get old enough to marry the person that God has planned for you, then you need to keep your promise to each other and to God. You know, I think our favorite puppets have another song.
Number 7. Do not commit adultery. That means be faithful to your husband or wife.
When you grow up big and strong, you'll be ready to set sail out upon the seas of life, and you will never fail. When you find the husband or the wife that God has planned for you,
you'll never cheat, serve them well, and remember to be true.
Be true to your mate. 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 'Cause life's a ship.
When the storms of life are trying to blow you overboard, don't forget your promise to your mate and to the Lord.
What God has joined together, let no man tear apart. Remember this little song and sing it from the heart.
Be true to your mate. 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 'Cause life's a ship, we're sailing on. You need your mate to keep you strong. So be true. Be true to your mate. Be true to your mate.
Okay, guys, let's review a really famous Bible story about a guy that honored his father, commandment 5, had every reason to have his brothers killed, but chose to love them instead, commandment 6, and said no to adultery, commandment 7. So all these things were in one Bible story? Let me explain. Let's do the quick rundown version of Joseph. Joseph had 11 brothers. Could you imagine having 11 brothers? Oh my goodness, that was a lot of brothers. But Joseph was the favorite son of Jacob. And because he was the favorite son, he was given a coat of many colors. Kind of like the shirt I'm wearing today. Lots of colors in it, right? And that set him apart. And to make matters worse for his brothers to think that They were jealous of Joseph. Joseph actually had some dreams that basically showed that his brothers were going to bow down and worship him. Oh, that wasn't very good either. But Joseph still said that. And so that made Joseph's brothers very, very jealous. So the brothers actually wanted to kill Joseph. But instead, they sold him into slavery for 20 pieces of silver. So whenever he was sold as a slave, he was in Potiphar's house. Now Potiphar was pretty high in command in Egypt. And Joseph was a slave in Potiphar's house until he was accused of a crime that he didn't even commit. You know, Potiphar's wife, remember Potiphar was married to a lady they called Potiphar's wife, and she really liked Joseph. But Joseph knew that she was married, and he refused her advances. So Joseph actually obeyed the seventh commandment, do not commit adultery. Okay? He knew that to not commit adultery and to break any promise that married couples make. But Potiphar's wife got angry, and she told her husband a lie that all of it was Joseph's fault. And of course, Potiphar was mad, and so he threw Joseph into prison. Ugh. Joseph was in prison for 2 years. But at the end of his 2 years, Pharaoh, the ruler of Egypt, had some strange dreams, and no one could interpret the dreams for him. But one of Pharaoh's servants said, "Hey, there's this guy that I met in prison that interpreted my dream. Maybe he can interpret yours." And so that's how Joseph got out of prison, because he interpreted Pharaoh's dream. Now, Pharaoh's dream was kind of a wacky dream. You ever had like a really weird dream and stuff? Yeah, that's what Pharaoh did. But the meaning of the dream that Pharaoh had was that for 7 years, there would be plenty of food. There would be rains and everything would grow, be lush crops and all that kind of stuff. But then after the 7 years, there would be 7 years of famine. That would mean no rain, nothing grows, nada. So in order to keep Egypt safe and fed so people wouldn't die of starvation, Pharaoh put Joseph in charge of cultivating all the food, making sure everyone had plenty to eat, to store the food, and make sure everything was good. So whenever the 7 years of famine came, that they actually had some food to eat. So Joseph went from being in the prison to second in command, only to Pharaoh. Wow, that's God's favor, isn't it? So the famine that actually came to Egypt affected not just Egypt, but the land surrounding it. So Joseph's brothers actually came to Egypt looking for food because they heard that, hey, there's this guy in Egypt and he has stored up all this food and we're hungry. There's nothing that can grow here. We need to go buy some food. So they trekked all the way from Canaan to Egypt. Now whenever the brothers came and tried to buy food, Joseph recognized them. Oh, that's my brothers that sold me into slavery. They wanted to kill me. Oh my. But the 11 brothers, they didn't know that it was Joseph. They had no clue. And so they bowed before him, just like his dream. So how do you think Joseph felt as his brothers bowed before him? He actually cried and had to go to another room to compose himself. And then he came back in. He couldn't take their lives. He knew that their lives were valuable, even though they had done him wrong so many years before. Remember, they were the ones that put him in prison as a slave in Egypt. So Joseph knew that their lives were valuable. God loved them and he loved them too. He obeyed the sixth commandment about not taking anyone's life. He didn't kill his brothers. And then Joseph revealed himself to his brothers. "Hey guys, it's me, Joseph." So after Joseph got reacquainted with his brothers, Joseph asked his brothers to come live in Egypt with him. So his brothers went back home, packed up their belongings and their families, including their father, Jacob. and they moved to Egypt. Now when Joseph's brothers and father arrived in Egypt, Joseph made sure that his father had the best parcel of land that Pharaoh had given them. So Joseph obeyed the fifth commandment by honoring his father, by treating him well and taking care of him.
Hey kids, did you know that every man, woman, boy, and girl is going to live forever somewhere? Either in heaven or in hell. We need to learn the Ten Commandments and we need to use them every day in order to live a life that's pleasing to God. We especially need to remember to honor our parents every day and throughout your life, and to keep every promise that we make to people and to God. We also need to value the life that God has given to those we meet, and we need to help lead them to Jesus every day. Wherever you find yourself in a situation where you aren't quite sure what to do, there's an old phrase that I learned as a kid. WWJD. And that means, what would Jesus do? Would Jesus love them? Of course. He would love every person he meets. And he would pray with them. That is exactly what we should do. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, I thank you, Lord, for every breath that you've given me in this body. Lord, help me every single day to keep my promises to everyone I meet. Lord, help me to use every breath in my body, Lord, to bring people closer to you. Lord, I ask you, give these children a desire to witness and to love people every day and to truly show your love. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Kidz Praiz, Kidz Praiz, what the best Kidz Praiz in town.